I don't know if I said this right, but I'm going to just say it again. If you don't have this kind of a project in your town or in your neighborhood, what you're supposed to do with fishing line is cut it up into, you know, 6 to 10 inch pieces and, you know, dispose of it in the trash that way. You know, I hope people, you know, could remember to do that as well.
You know, on that point, one of the things that would be good to let people know, too, is that even if plastics are cut into small pieces, you know, smaller and smaller pieces, then they just get ingested by something, and they, you know, it's not like it goes away. So
The best thing 600 years. I don't know how they test that out, because this has been around for about 50 or 60.
And they're finding that, you know, smaller and smaller particles of plastic and smaller and smaller organisms.
Right.
So even if it's small it's enough scary. For a copepod to eat it, it's still in, you know, it gets to become part of the food chain, and we don't want to have that happen. So this is a way to make sure it stays out of there, and even those 1.5 inch pieces don't end up in some animal.
Exactly. Thank you. How you ladies doing down here? Wow. You know, I just want to thank you guys all for coming, taking the time out of your day, and, you know, to help support this project, because, you know, it makes it much easier and
you're welcome.
Gets
it's
it going. And it's fun, and maybe the other towns can call upon y'all to come out and say, we need some help.
We'll be there.
Now, these units cost about $50 each to build when you involve the stickers, the glue, the PVC, and also the installation materials. You know, you have to, you know, have a little bit of money left over there for the, you know, to install them. So, you know, it's a good thing to try to remember if you want to, you know, a certain number of them that you're going to build. They're about $50 each. Much cheaper when you use this sewer drain pipe. And, you know, there's also green pipe, but, you know, the continuity across the country is this white pipe. So I think it's a, you know, good idea to try to, so wherever you go, whether it's Florida or New Jersey or wherever, that you're going to see this white, you know, periscopic type of tube, and you'll know what to do with it. Wow, everyone's on the sticker thing. I think we're going to do it. We have about 7 minutes left. So another good thing is to, you know, we've got these, I made up these little brochures, and it's good to have maybe in the town halls when people go to get a fishing license or a clamming license or something like that, that this is available for them. So even if they don't see these units out on the beach, they could see the they could read the literature and realize that there's a place to dispose of the fishing line.
Debbie, you got one of these?
If you are running out, that means that we're almost done.
Okay.
We should have 30 some odd of these things.
There's not. I don't think so. I don't.
Well, there's a bunch down on the floor.
Okay.
Oh, is that the problem?
Well, you got it. No problem.
Yeah.
False warning.
Did I?
So, do you think the town of Southampton might be open to this project?
I think it would be a wonderful idea, and I think they would, particularly if we, you know, tried to get sponsors the mm-hmm. way you did, and help, you know, keep the cost down to the taxpayers and.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's something that should be in everywhere, and I think the signs should be in fishing marinas and everything, just to stop the practice of the tackle just being thrown out like it is.
You know what was really interesting when I went into the marinas, one of the places, Whitewater Tackle, I think it was in Hampton Bays, asked me for two of these because they said they would fill one box up in 3 days. You know, because they re-spool. You come in at the beginning of the season, and they said usually they just throw it in the dumpster. And they were just so excited, and everyone was so happy and thought it was such a good idea. You know, I was a little nervous going in, you know, knock, knock, hi, you know, would you like my box or whatever? But people were just so nice and happy and excited, and that really made it much easier.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's amazing how many times a simple solution is what people have been looking for, and all you have to do is have the right idea and put it in front of people, and it's not a big hurdle to overcome. And you've got the idea, and you've got the product, and it makes it easier for somebody who runs a tackle shop or somebody who runs a marina or somebody who's thinking about, you know, going out fishing or renting a boat.
Sure.
You know, you put it right there and it's easy for them to get a hold of. Mm-hmm. And I think the message behind it, as you say, is on so many levels mm-hmm. that you can get the importance of this and raise awareness just by seeing it. Even people who don't know what it is makes you look closer and start thinking
right.
and asking yourself some questions. And that leads you to start thinking about, geez, all that line that I've been seeing on the, you know, it does get wrapped around birds. It does cause a problem.
I think everybody has seen an animal with trailing some fishing line.
Mm-hmm.
I've had one in my yard in the past 2 months or so. And we untangled it. We kept the line and untangled it, and off he went.
Right.
I mean, it was like a sign, like, right. Debbie, you're doing a good thing, you know? Like, you know, so it was pretty cool.
Yeah. So I think you'll see, and I do think the interest of other towns and other communities is probably pretty high.
I hope so. We live on an island full of fishermen.
So hopefully that will help to spread the word. And
woohoo!
That's not good.
What's good about these? These are the indoor, of course. They're made of cardboard. The spools. You know, the spools go in and the fishing line. I just told the marina owners, just throw it all in one box and send it back. And again, kudos to the Berkeley Conservation Institute, because, you know, they didn't have to do this by any means. And if you go and research this program, you'll see them mentioned over and over. You know, so they, I think they are the leaders in this initiative.
Well, it's great. And they've also found, you know, a lot of people always look at the economic side of this thing. You know, what's this really going to do? How's it going to help us economically? And they have found a way to take this material and turn it into a product that is then marketable.
Absolutely.
And that makes it.
And again, enhances the environment even more. That's not just tackle boxes they're making. Mm-hmm. They're making, you know, fish habitat.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah. And so once you can make that connection for people, you've pretty much got them on every level. If you care about wildlife, it makes a difference. If you care about litter and trash, if you care about recycling, or if you care about raw economics, a project like this really hits on all of those points.
Sure.
So it's got to, I'm sure it'll work.
And, you know, I think it's good, too, like if a Boy Scout group, you know, or a Girl Scout group wants to, you know, if they have to do a little community service or a high school.
Right.
You know, because, again, it's easy. And there's so much about this online. This is not something that I've made up by any means, and it's really nice because all the literature and the paperwork and stuff like that, and the stickers, it's feel free to use this.
Yeah.
You know, they're not like charging you or, you know, trying to keep a copyright or something. They want it to be.
Yeah, you could,
enhanced.
You know, you could very easily have, let's say, a scout troop be stewards of three or four of these in a particular community, so that, you know, the first group would build them, and the second and third group maintain them and look after them, and also start to, you know, look into some of the data that gets collected as a result of all of this.
Oh, that's a good idea.
And start to connect the amount of, you know, plastic being found on their own beaches with, you know, what they're seeing and what's happening in the local environment. A lot of times, you know, anytime I've ever done a beach cleanup of any type, people come away with four or five, you know, ideas about, oh, my God, I can't believe how many plastic bottles, or I can't believe how much fishing line, or whatever it is, you know, bottle caps. And it's on the ground evidence of what's out there that you just don't think about every day as you're driving by at 40 miles an hour. This is the way to really get people thinking about it for the long term.
You know, I have one in the Montauk Chamber of Commerce.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have fishermen going in there, but I put it in there so that, and I explained to them, for people just to see it and go, wait, what is that? You know, and to get them to think, and there's one in the town hall.
Sure.
Nobody's bringing fishing line into the town hall, but it's been sitting in there, and just to make people think.
Those questions are exactly what get people to start to put this in the front of their mind, and even if they don't fish, they know somebody who fishes, or they can go home and say, hey, I saw this thing in town hall, and did you know, and remember when we found that stuff on the beach?
Right.
All of those connections really help us to get to that next level where this is automatic or it's intuitive for us to start taking better care the shoreline, to start picking up after ourselves, and to not mind picking up after others because you have something to do with, you know, the trash that you've picked up or the waste line.
Absolutely. And, you know, I'm sure people have heard this before, but just about everything on land that's litter ends up in the sea. I mean, it all ends up washing down through drains or through blowing or, you know, it's not people directly, you know, deciding, oh, I'm going to throw this in the ocean. It just kind of migrates.
And here, you know, we see that and know that very well because at the end of every road, at the end of every street, you know, we've got an awful lot of water that's heading in. So anything that gets washed down and washed in is finding its way into the bays and harbors.
That's right. Any closing comments, Virginia, Bob? We're running out of time.
Well, again, I just think it's a wonderful thing, and I'm just so glad to be here with everybody.
Yeah, and thank you guys so much for taking the time out of your day to come. I really appreciate it. And the animals appreciate it.
I'm sure I could speak for everybody here to thank you for the initiative and the energy to get this moving so that we could all not only participate in something like this, but to see community action in the way that you've brought it home here at East Hampton, which is a great model for everybody.
Thank you. Okay, bye.